You can Arc enable your SQL Server to get the benefits of Azure while remaining on-prem if you can't migrate yet. I'm here with Principal Partner Solutions Architect Dale Kirby. He is an expert in this topic. Dale, do you want to show us how it looks like?
Yeah, definitely, Fede. Let me go ahead and share my screen. And what you'll see here is that I'm in the Azure portal. I'm in the Azure Arc, you know, section of the Azure portal. And if I scroll down just a little bit, you'll see I have SQL Server instances here. So as you were saying, what we can do is we can take our on-premises SQL servers and we can manage them through Azure, through via Azure Arc this way. And it's really easy to get this set up. It's really just a matter of I can come right here in Azure portal. I click add and connect. And it's kind of that simple. I provide some details about my server. And what Azure Portal is going to do is it's going to generate a PowerShell script that I then run on that server to onboard it. Now, there's other ways to onboard servers as well if you don't want to take the manual approach, but this is kind of a simple approach that you get a server onboarded and then you're off to the races. And then once you have that server onboarded, you can start to do things like manage your ESUs with, on that server. So we've got a server I've already onboarded here. For example, this SQL server right here happens to be running SQL Server 2012 as Azure Arc is telling me. So again, Azure Arc is telling me data about the server that lives on premises. And then if I scroll down, I see things in the SQL Server configuration like license type and ESU subscription.
That's great. So you can choose your ESU subscription there. You might have some options. Do you want to show us?
Mm-hmm. Yep. So if I click on this, you can see I've got the option to go ahead and enable this server. It is running a version that's eligible for ESU. And then I can pick the kind of license type that I'm using for this ESU. So in this case, I've got selected license with software assurance. So if you've got hybrid use benefit and software assurance, you're eligible to apply that to ESUs. And you're also, and I think this is really neat, you're also able to purchase ESUs directly through as part of your Azure subscription in a pay-as-you-go model. And that's only possible through Azure Arc this way. And that to me is a really powerful option, particularly for customers that might not have hybrid, might not have software assurance and are looking for a way to kind of manage their portfolio of on-prem servers that are eligible for these ESUs.
That's awesome. We actually had a conversation with Adam Burke about precisely how those benefits are incredible for our partners and customers. So once you're onboarded, ESUs, licensing types, I'm sure there's more we can do here, right?
Yeah, absolutely. You can see we can also manage our SQL Server licensing type. So that's a really nice benefit to be able to use in cloud. But we also have things like a best practices assessment, which will tell you, you know, things like how well your solution is doing. There's a ton of detail in there. Automated patching, integration with Defender. There's a lot of power you get once you onboard a server, a SQL Server like this to Azure Arc that you can now realize through management through the cloud.
That's incredible, Dale. We actually should do some videos on that. But in the meantime, we'd love to know what questions you have for Dale. Leave those in the comments and we'll make sure to take a look.